Hi friends, welcome to Devrat Knowledge Villa. You are watching our English video series of operating system and learning disk scheduling. Today's our topic is look scheduling. Before today, we have discussed FCFS, SSTF, scan and C-scan scheduling. So guys, if you are still remain to watch our last video of C-scan scheduling, so please click here into the top upper right corner I button and please watch the video of C-scan scheduling. Before the C-scan, we have discussed the scan scheduling. So what actually happened into the scan scheduling? So there is one limitation of scan scheduling, that is unnecessary move till endpoints. It means after reaching the 184, there is no single request after 184. But still head was traveling toward the end of the track. It means head was travel up to the 199 and then move return towards the downward direction. So that is one limitation. Head is traveling 184 to 199 and again 199 to 184. It means 30 units seek times more over there. So to reduce these 30 seek times, we will discuss today's our topic is look scheduling. So what is actually happening into the look scheduling? See, first with the few non-technical examples, look like lift. Whenever look like some person is going to the third floor from the ground floor by using a lift. So what's happened? That person will left the lift from third floor, and then after there is a three more floors are available, like fourth, fifth and sixth floor. And if there is no person is available into the lift to travel towards the upper floor and no one is waiting for the lift at upper floor, so lift will come return from third floor to ground floor if someone is waiting for going to upwards. So there is no need to travel up to the sixth floor if no one is waiting at upper floor and no one want to go at upper floor. So lift is coming back from the third floor only. Same thing, this thing is happen for the like shuttle rickshaw. Look like one certain shuttle rickshaw is traveling from Sarkhej to Gandhinagar and Gandhinagar to Sarkhej. So like into the first trip, rickshaw is traveling towards the Sarkhej to Gandhinagar, and if no persons are or no passengers are available up to the Pathik Ashram, all passengers have completed their journey to the info city only, so that rickshaw can turn back from the info city to Sarkhej. So that is the logic is we can implement with the where actually load is less. But if you suppose consider same situation with the train or bus, so what is happen? Like some train is traveling from Delhi to Bombay and Bombay to Delhi. So suppose train started their journey from Delhi and traveling towards the Bombay, and before reaching the Bombay, at a last 2 second stop, all passengers have left the train and no passenger remain inside the train. So can driver turn back the train from last 2 second stop toward the back Delhi? So no, this thing is not possible because many peoples are waiting to travel from another end to first end. So where actually load is greater, so at that time this thing is not possible. So we can't do this type of situation look like train, bus or flights. Get it? So let's see what actually going to happen. Actually our data was previous one look like the previous examples 99, 184, 38, 123, 15, 125, 66 and 68, and head start at 54 and moving upwards. So let's take with the same examples. We are going to start from the 54 and our head is moving upwards. So up to which end our head will move? Up to the last request. It means last request is 184 during the upward direction. So head will move towards the 184 only. After reaching that point, head will look, is any more requests are available from 184 to 199? So no, there is no request available from 184 to 199. So no need to go towards the 199. Head will return back from 184 and start reading or writing towards the downward direction and then fulfill the request of 38 and 15. So that is the logic behind look scheduling. Let calculate the seek time. So, as you know very well how to calculate the seek time, total seek time would be 299. Get it? So, what are the advantages and disadvantages of loop scheduling? Let discuss first advantages of loop scheduling. That is, first one is better performance than scan. Why? Because into the scan scheduling, there was total 329 unit seek time. Here, we reduce it up to the 30 units. It is depends on data. It's not, I can't say that is exactly, but it is depends on data. So, we are able to overcome this limitation. We can reduce the total seek time. It means to after reducing the seek time, there is better performance than scan scheduling. Another thing, better for less load. As per we have discussed, we can do this activity look like with the lift, with the rickshaw. Get it? So, where actually load is less, at that time we can use the loop scheduling. Let's see what are the limitations. Overhead to find last request. Yeah, that is one limitation. Let explain what is it. After reaching 184, head will look towards the upward direction. Is there any request is remain to 184 to 199? So, after getting there is no request after 184, then and then head will turn back, otherwise head will go upwards. So, there is need to look after reaching 184. So, to calculate any request is remain or not. So, again it will take some amount of time here at from this point. So, there is need to look from 184 to 189, if any request is available, then and then head will travel upward, otherwise head will move return back. So, this thing head have to calculate at every point. Anything request is available in this direction, then and then head will go ahead, otherwise head will move back. So, every point there is need to look. So, it will take a few amounts of time to look into next direction. So, that is overhead to find last request. And one more limitation, that is not used for high load. Yeah, we can't implement this type of policies into trains, bus or flights. So, whenever actually load is greater one, it means request of reading and writing of data is very much higher. So, we can't use this type of loop scheduling for reading and writing purpose. Another thing, increase waiting time then C-scan. Whereas into the C scan, what we have discussed, into the downward directions, head was not reading or writing anything. After reaching from 199 to 0, head was moving back without doing any procedure of reading and writing, and then again start same activity from our actual end. So, head is moving quickly. It means whenever head is moving back without writing or reading, it means head is moving very much faster. So, after reaching this end, head can start the same procedure look like here. So, it means head is moving quickly, so it will reduce the waiting time. So, right now in this, that is a limitation, it is increased waiting time as compared to C scan. Right now waiting time for the 38 and 15, it is very much higher as compared to C scan scheduling. So, that is one limitation also. So, I hope you are understanding very well. Still, if you have any query regarding to this loop scheduling, so you can post into the comment box. I will try my best to solve your query. Thanks for watching Devrat Knowledge Villa. Thank you very much.